Be positive, but don't test positive. Be wise and sanitize. With these words, I am starting my session. A pleasant greetings to one and all viewing this session. Hope all are safe and doing great. Myself, Seshadri from Palakkad, doing my articleship from Palakkad, here before you to deliver a small session on the topic Ind AS 10 combined with SA 560, that is accounting and auditing of subsequent events. So let us move into this session. Now this session is not going to be like displaying a PowerPoint session and explaining. Rather, it's going to be a board teaching, or we can tell it as a chalk teaching, whereby explaining with the help of a board. So I hope, I believe that board is clear and my voice is also audible. So I request every viewers to stay relaxed and listen to the session. So we will move into the session. Ind AS 10 first part, part 1 Ind AS 10, part 2 SA 560. So first part, Ind AS 10, events occurring after reporting date. Now we know that 1/4/2019 to 31/3/2020 is a financial year. This is the financial year 1920. Hope there is no doubt in that. Now once the financial year gets over, we know that the board of directors will be going through the financials. They will be approving the financials, and then audit takes place. After the audit takes place, what happens? General meeting will be conducted, then resolutions will be passed. This is the normal routine cycle in a particular, in a company generally. That is financial year, board of directors approval, then audit will take place. Theoretically audit will take place, and of course we have to inform to stock exchange, we have to conduct general meeting. This is the normal procedure of a company. Now what this Ind AS 10 is about is about events occurring after reporting date. Now 31/3 is said to be the reporting date. Reporting date for financial year 1920 is 31/3/2020, and the period up to which the board of directors approve the financial statements, that is from 31/3 to the date on which board of directors approve the financial statement, this period is called as post balance sheet period. Once again, financial year, reporting date, the gap between 31/3 and the date on which board of directors approval. In this example, 15/5 is our date. So this date is called, up to 31/3 to 15/5, this period is called post balance sheet period. And please remember, only look at board of directors approval date. All these dates please ignore it. Although if it is given in the question, please ignore those dates. Keep your focus only on board of directors approval date. Now this period is called post balance sheet period, and what this Ind AS is telling us, there are certain events which occur between this period. There are certain events which occur between this period and which has a significant impact in the business. What is it? There are certain events which occur during this period, and those events can impact the business to some extent. It can materially impact the business. Those items are called as events occurring after reporting date, which is being told in Ind AS 10. That is post balance sheet period. The events occurring during this period, please remember, up to board of directors approval, during this period, these events are called as events occurring after reporting date. Now what are these events? Please relax. After learning completely only, we will be able to get a proper idea of what this Ind AS is telling about. Now events occurring reporting date are basically of two types. One is adjusting event, and another is non-adjusting events. I think up to this a proper clarity is there. Financial year, post balance sheet period, always remember board of directors approval date, and this certain events are called as events occurring after reporting date. What are these events? It can be adjusting or non-adjusting. Adjusting event means those events. What is adjusting events and what is non-adjusting events? Adjusting events are those events which are evidence of the condition, which are evidence of the conditions existing as on 31.3. Means what? That is, this event is happening in the post-balance sheet period because the condition was existing as on 31.3. That is, this event is occurring during the post-balance sheet period because the condition for this occurrence of this event was existing on 31.3. So, adjusting event means what? Condition on 31.3 was there. Condition for happening of this event was existing during this period or during 31.3. That is why this event has took place in post-balance sheet period. They are called adjusting. What is non-adjusting? Non-adjusting means condition was not there as on 31.3, which means that it is an indication of an event occurring after, indication of a condition which arises after 31.3. That is, non-adjusting events are those events where the condition for happening of this event was not there as on reporting date. So first thing, adjusting means condition should be there as on 31.3. Non-adjusting means condition for happening of this event was not there as on reporting date. Now, what you are supposed to do? When it is an adjusting event, you have to make certain accounting adjustment entries as on 31.3 in the financials of 1920. Adjusting event means accounting adjustments should be made. Non-adjusting events means you don't make any accounting adjustments. So what you will do? You only have to make disclosure. You only have to make disclosure in the notes to accounts. So adjusting event, again, you have to make accounting entries plus you make disclosure. No issues. You have to make disclosures also. But non-adjusting means you only make the disclosure. Hope you are very clear with what adjusting event and what non-adjusting event is. Adjusting event means condition for happening was existing, and thereby what happens is that you have to properly make accounting adjustments and disclose it. Non-adjusting means you just have to disclose it. Now we will directly move into some of the examples, then only we will be able to get a proper purview of what this Ind AS is speaking about. Now, customer became, in adjusting events, customer became insolvent on 10/4/2020. First checkpoint, look at the date. What is the date over here? 10/4/2020. Whether this date is coming in post balance sheet period as per our example? Yes, 10/4 is a post balance sheet period. First confusion is over. Second important thing, you have to check whether it is adjusting or non-adjusting. Customer became insolvent. Now, example is, during February, I made a sales to a customer worth rupees 70 lakh. But in March, he didn't pay me the money because of his financial struggles. But as on 10/4, he was declared insolvent by the court of law. And which means that, what is insolvency? Insolvency is a position where liability is greater than the asset. In simple term, we can tell. And insolvency is a big, long legal procedure. So, on 10/4, that person was declared insolvent. So, what we are trying to understand, during 31.3 itself, there was some financial struggle to him, and the condition was so existing that he will be declared insolvent in the near future. That is why he became insolvent. So, customer hasn't paid me money, so the management have to make suitable provision for bad debts as on 31/3/2020. Depending upon the impact in the financials, the management judgment, management has to properly make adjustment. That is why we are telling it as an adjusting event, or accounting adjustment should be made, because provision for bad debts has to be made as on 31/3. So that is what adjusting or accounting adjustment should be made. Similarly, settlement of the existing case. there was an existing case during this financial year. The order came during the post balance sheet period. So what happens? The condition for this case was there during the financial. That is why the order came. So when the order came, it was a liability for me to pay, let us say an example of 65 lakh. So what we will do is, again it is a litigation which we have to pay money. It is a liability, of course. So we have to make suitable provisions as on 31(3) for this foreseeable payment of this court case amount. And COVID-19 impact. We know that COVID has affected majority aspects of our life, and it has also made different sort of struggles for the industry as such, or economy as such, we can tell. Now COVID, again, majority is an adjusting event. Why? Because nationwide lockdown was being introduced or was announced on 25th March 2020, and we were so clear that on the post balance sheet period the lockdown situations will be there, and COVID-19, it was in condition existing as on 31-3. So we can clearly tell that COVID-19 issue is an condition which was existing as on 31-3. So majority is a COVID-19 impact. Majority aspects are adjusting event. So I believe that you are very clear with this aspect, adjusting events. Similarly, non-adjusting means what? Condition was not existing as on the reporting date. Now new court case on 10-5. First point is, look at the date. Date is 10-5. Of course it is a post balance sheet period. New court case, newly, or we can tell commencement of a new case. So what happens over there? Condition was existing, we won't tell. Basically a new case has come. It is because we are also not aware of that. So new case came, which is a very significant, please listen, key point, materiality matters. That is significance, other than the impact. That impact will play a very crucial role in the functioning of the business. So new court case, it is not a simple case, let it be a very major case. Okay, what happens? It is on 10-5, so post balance sheet period. It is an event occurring after reporting day. It is a non-adjusting event, so you need not make accounting adjustments. You only have to make the proper disclosure. Similarly, inventory got destroyed, asset got destroyed. Check the date 3-4-7-4, whether it is a post balance sheet period. Yes, first confusion is over. Second important thing, whether it is adjusting or non-adjusting. Event was existing as on 31-3, we won't tell, because inventory got fired because of some accident due to some electric short circuit, it got destroyed. So what happens is that we can't tell it as an adjusting event. Rather, it's going to be a non-adjusting event. We just have to make proper disclosures in the financial statements only. And very important, please remember this with you, dividend declared by the board. Now we know in company audit section 123, starting from section 123, we have learned about the provisions relating to dividend. Dividend will be declared by board, but it is not a liability. It becomes liability only when dividend is being declared in the annual general meeting and resolution is passed by the shareholders. It becomes a liability to whom? Management. So as on board approval date, whether dividend is a liability? No, it is not that a liability hasn't arise. It becomes liability only when approval of the shareholders comes into picture. So dividend declared by board in their board meeting, basically it is not a liability. When it is not a liability, whether we have to recognize it, we need not recognize unless it becomes a liability. So what happens is, dividend declared by board basically is a non-adjusting event. You just have to make proper disclosure. Very simple, interest and basically is telling about all these things only. But you have some checkpoints. Please remember that if any of the non-adjusting events is affecting the going concern of the organization materially. Let us take an example. Inventory got fired, asset got destroyed, everything got destroyed. What is happening over there? The management is of the view that we can't run business in future. It is so difficult for us. We are on the verge of liquidity. If management is virtually, certainly determining it, although it is a non-adjusting event, we have to make adjustments in the financials, because the fundamental accounting aspect which is going concern is affected. So thereby, so while writing in the exam also you can write this, when going concern is significantly materially affected, you have to, although it is a non-adjusting, you have to treat it as an adjusting event and make adjustments. This is one checkpoint. Second checkpoint, so first checkpoint is going concern. Second checkpoint is IFS, interim financial statements. Of course, Ind AS 10 is applicable to interim financial statement also. And we have one more checkpoint. Please keep this with you. Now, after board approval, auditor is conducting the audit. While audit is conducted, auditor is discovering a major fraud and auditor is asking the management to reopen the books, restate the books and reauthorize the financials. Let us say, let it be like on this date, let it be in the middle of 1st June, the audit got completed, audit report was not issued, but what happened was that auditor is a view of changing the financials. Board of directors approved with that. Board of directors is reauthorizing it. So what happens? Ind AS 10 is telling to us, up to the date on which board is reauthorizing, restating it, we have to take that also into consideration. This is what Ind AS 10 basically, briefly we are dealing with. I will just summarize it or recall it within 1 minute. That is, financial year, post balance sheet period, always remember board of directors approval date. Please ignore other date. Next, events occurring are basically of two types, adjusting and non-adjusting. Adjusting means it is an evidence of the condition which was existing on 31-3. Evidence, condition was there. That is why this event is happening. Non-adjusting means what? You just have to make disclosure only. Condition was not existing. Please remember these examples with you. Also checkpoint, going concern and interim financial statements and reauthorization of the financials. This is a complete outward picture of Ind AS 10. Yes, now we will discuss one question from our textbook. A very simple question, just to have a brief understanding of what we have learned. Now the question is as such. ABC, it is from Test Your Knowledge of New Financial Reporting Textbook. ABC Limited is a trading concern of laptop. On 31-3, the company has 50 laptops. So on 31-3, 50 laptop it has. And the amount of the cost of this laptop is ₹45,000. Now, because, that is, the question is, on 15th-4, on 15th-4, the advanced version of the laptop was introduced in the market and the laptop price of the existing laptops crushed down to ₹35,000. So what is it? Because of the updation in the technology in the market, the existing laptop, the price of this existing laptop, which was 45,000, it came down to 35,000 as on 15th-4. Now, company is of the view that this event took place after 31-3 and so note relevant for the period, comment on this regard. So we know this is the question. 31-3, 50 laptop worth ₹45,000, 31-3, so it was a closing stock for them, no sales happened on 31-3 further. On 15-4, it crushed down to 35,000. Let us, in this question, it is not given the date on which board of directors are approved. So, with a note, we should understand this question. So, I believe that we are assuming that 15-4 is within the period of post-balance sheet period. So, with that purview, we are telling the answer. We know that inventory should be valued at cost or NRV, whichever is lower. And because of the upgradation of the technology, the net realizable value, NRV, of the inventory crushed down by 10,000. So we know that as on 30/3, laptop was there, the condition was existing. Because of the upgradation, what happened was that it crushed down to 35,000. So it was so clear that inventory should be valued. We know foreseeable losses should be considered as per prudence, and also as per Ind AS 10, it was so clear that it is an adjusting event. NRV should be revalued, and we will be valuing inventory at cost or NRV, whichever is lower. So this is the example of a small light question which has been taken from FR study material. So this is the complete aspect of Ind AS 10. So let us move on into the next part, that is essay 560. Now we are on the second part, that is essay 560, auditor's responsibility in relation to subsequent events. Please look the same example we discussed in Ind AS 10, financial year 1920. This is board of directors approval. On 36, audit was completed. Audit report was issued to management. And on 37 is the annual general meeting date on which the financial results are being given to the public. This is the normal structure. Now, what essay 560 is telling about? The events occurring between 31/3 and audit report date, plus facts known to the auditor after the report provided to the management but before it has been issued to the public, is what essay 560 is telling about. So essay 560 means events between 31/3 and audit report date, and facts about this subsequent events, about this intestine period, known to the auditor after the report has been provided to management. So here, what is the two most important cases? Now we know that this period is covered under Ind AS 10, there is no doubt in that. But subsequent events, this event between 31/3 and audit report, I told you one checkpoint in Ind AS 10, if board is reauthorizing the financials, we have to consider that period also. So that is why this standard is telling or covering subsequent events as a period between 31/3 and audit report date, and facts known to the auditor. Now we have two cases, please remember this, how the auditor should deal with the situation. If auditor knew all the facts about the subsequent events at the time of or while conducting the audit itself, then what will happen? Auditor might have considered its effect in the financial, and audit report, either it can be modified or unmodified depending upon the circumstance. Auditor will be issuing the report. Auditor is safe. Auditor came to know about all the facts of the subsequent events during the time of audit itself. So auditor would have been considered it in his report. That is the first case. Second case is about facts known to the auditor after report provided to management before issued to the public. Now here we have two cases in it. One thing is that if the management amends the financial, so one second, facts known to the auditor after the report is issued to management before issued to public, so auditor will be calling the management and asking them, please, subsequent event has been occurred, I came to know about it, please management, please change the financial, amend the financials. Okay, management is agreeing, management is amending the financials. Or sometimes management may not amend the financials. One case is management will be amending financials, management may not be amending financials. So what the auditor should do in this situation is, first situation, when the management is amending the financials, the auditor has to revise the audit report. Auditor have to provide an amended audit report. That's it. Secondly, if management is not amending the financials, auditor have to get a legal advice and issue a public notice in the newspaper to disregard this financial. Very simple, over. That's it. Now we understood what subsequent events is. Now it is the duty of the auditor to perform audit procedures to obtain sufficient appropriate, relevant, reliable audit evidence as per SA 500 about this subsequent events. How he will get the evidence? Now, please remember, only 4 points we have. It is very easy to remember also. Please read through this. First thing is, read the minutes. Which minutes? Read the board minutes. Read through the board minutes so that you will be able to get an understanding of the subsequent events. Second is, obtain the procedures performed by the management. How the management has performed the procedures. Depending upon that, the auditor can come to a proper conclusion about how the management has dealt with the subsequent events. Next is, ask. Ask. I will give you what ask is. Now, next, lastly, read the latest interim financial statements, if any. Next year, interim financial statement, if it is available, if you read through this, you will be able to get an understanding of subsequent event if there or not. Now, how to easily remember this in the examination is, please look at the first word of these four sentences, R-O-A-R. If you remember this word, R-O-A-R, roar, if you remember this word with you, you can easily write in the examination also how the auditor will be collecting evidences or what is the audit techniques used by the auditor in collecting evidences to check in regarding with subsequent events. Read the board minutes, obtain the procedures performed by the management, ask, and finally read the latest interim financial statements. Now, one hint point I told you, what is this ask? Ask means inquire. You make some question mark questions. What is it? Now, first part one, I told you some of the examples of adjusting and non-adjusting events, like customer becoming insolvent, commencement of new cases, inventory destruction, asset got destroyed, all these things. These are the examples of adjusting and non-adjusting events. Please, no need to buy heart, but keep this in your mind. You just convert that into question mark and you frame questions so that you can write what to ask the management. Very simple. No misconceptions or ambiguities. This is very simple. No need to worry also in this regard. Please remember, read the minutes, obtain the procedures of management, ask and read the latest IFS. Ask means you frame questions like, you understand the examples of the adjusting and non-adjusting events, and based on that you put up question marks. It is very clear with that. So I think that we are nearing to the end of this session. First we discussed about Ind AS 10, basically post balance sheet period, adjusting, non-adjusting. Adjusting means condition should be existing as on reporting date. You have to make accounting adjustments. We discussed the examples. Similarly, we went through non-adjusting events also. We discussed examples. We discussed three checkpoints also. And then we later went into subsequent events. How the auditor should deal with this situation. If management is amending the report, amending the financials, you also have to amend or revise the audit report. And if the management is not amending, you should be safe. You have to provide proper notice in the newspaper to disregard the financials. It's a simple thing. And how to collect the audit evidence, ROAR, please remember it, R-O-A-R, read the board minutes, obtain procedures of management, ask and read the latest interim financial statements. I hope that this concept in the Ind AS 10 combined with SA 560 is very clear with everyone. Thanking Sikasa Kozhikode branch for giving me such an opportunity to take up a session, and thanking all the viewers for watching this session patiently. And this is Sheshadri signing off. Thank you everyone. Thank you.